Hi guys, welcome to you all to learn R commands. In this presentation, we can look at objects, vectors, and regular arithmetic functions will be learned. Now let us look at an object. See, object, R programming is also an object-oriented programming language, as it stores everything in the objects. In every R session, objects are created and stored in the database, which is called .R data. Like we can store this into .R is a file. In that data, R data, the data files are going to be stored. So now how to create this object? Let us see the creation of the object here. For example, you are going to be use any of the variable, suppose x value. As we discussed earlier, some assignment operator is like this. See, x value is 12 is the assigned to x value. So now you want to display this x value so that it display as a 12. Here the x val is the object. The value of 12 is assigned to this object. So how to give this object? This object names we follow as it is like other languages. What are the variable names? We can give any variable name. The rules of the variable name are very clear. It must be start with an alphabet. Should not use any special symbols except underscore. So like that, those are the rules used to create these object names. Like for example, I will create here another object name x value. Assignment operator we can also directly give like this. So 29. Okay, want to display this? I told you we can use y value. It is able to print directly here x value, x val, and y value. These two are the objects. These two are the objects created to store our data automatically. So now these objects are created or assigned these values to the variable in other way. We can also apply some arithmetic operations directly in this. Let us see z is equals to x value, as for that x value plus y value. So these two are performed addition and stored in the other object, which is called z. So 12 plus 29 is 41 is stored in this z object. So like this, we can also create another object assignment operator like x value multiply with y value. See, look at this object 348. So like this, we can able to create and many number of objects, and all those objects are able to store those values and able to keep along with those objects. So in this way, we can create all arithmetic operations also can perform on the objects. Like similarly, we can use subtract, or simply s is an object, and then we can use x val subtract y value. So then display s is -17. So like this, we can perform any arithmetic operations on the object directly. This is the way we can do create many different objects, and these objects can be stored the different values. So as for the agenda, we have look at object assignment. So like this, we can assign the objects in this form. So now we can use object storage. So now like the objects can be stored permanently into the database of R. We need to know what are the objects so far we used. We need to list out those objects with using command ls. Ls. It displayed the list of objects Actually, just now we created x value, y value, z. This also stores the, in the previous session, whatever the objects created, those also can be displayed. Here in the list of objects, with using the command of ls, we got A, capital A, E, MUL, Q, like this. So these are all actually displayed in the alphabetical order. Just you might have doubt here, we created only objects x value, y value, z, MUL and s. But what about other? These other objects are displayed which are created in the earlier sessions. So like this, we need to get the list of objects which are used in this presently, then we can use the command is called ls. Ls indicates list of objects. Okay. And can we able to remove any objects as for this agenda? Yes, we can remove the objects straight away. We can use rm and which objects you are trying to delete. So then we can mention that object. So for example, I want to delete the object which is called z. Okay. So now we can list those objects. Z is not available. Look at, I just remove, rm is the command is for remove the objects from this list of objects, and rm z. So we need to remove more than one. We can use, try to see, rm z comma a comma x. Let us try. Look at, here z is not found, z is not available, ax is available. So we'll try rm, because z is already deleted. So it is showing an warning message that z is not found. So we need to remove only r, capital A, small a, comma e, for example. Let us try for this. Object A is not found. Okay. In this case, A, which is the object we used in the earlier session, but the object data is deleted, is not available, but it show in the list. So present objects we are trying to remove, rm x v a l u. So look at, this we are trying to remove, it is removed, then we try to see the list is available or not. So in that list, x value is deleted from this list. Okay. Now, actually the A is not available, but it is by display this list of objects at present what are available in the system. So this is the way we can able to remove the list, and we can also remove the list like with a different pattern. Like for example, remove the list, remove rm, we can use a command in this list ls. Okay, rm, we are trying to remove which are available at right now, which is already used earlier. Let us see, it is also removed at right now, and we can use list, and the multiplication mul is the object is removed. So this is the way we can use to remove the objects from the list.